Hello everyone. So today we have with us Dr. B. Ganesh Babu, who is the principal of SRM DRP Engineering College, Trichy. Sir, I'd like to welcome you to the series called as Thoughtful Leaders on behalf of CollegeDunia.com. So, sir, I would want you to introduce yourself to our audience so that they'll also get to know you.
Good morning, CollegeDunia and the viewers. I am Dr. Ganesh Babu, principal of SRM DRP Engineering College, Trichyapalli. I am very happy to share my thoughts about education, about our institution to College Duniya, through the College Duniya to all the educationalists and all the aspirants, engineering aspirants. Good morning all.
So
here our SRM DRP Engineering College is situated in Trichyapalli, which is central part of Tamil Nadu. It is coming under the SRM group of institutions. It is a well-renowned SRM group. Here, not only in the metro cities, in the second-tier cities like Trichyapalli also, our SRM group is giving educational services with engineering college, arts and science college, medical college, nursing college, everything in a same campus. Now, in this year, it has been started that SRM IST off-campus in Trichyapalli also. Such a way, we are having a very big campus in the Trichyapalli. So, always we are maintaining that SRM brand with the quality.
Great to know, sir. So, like starting with the first thing, sir, I would like to know that, sir, what is your philosophy of the leadership, and how do you think your leadership style is?
Sir, here in the educational institution, it is a purely service oriented institution. When we are talking about the leadership, being a leader. Think out of box thinking. We need to think out of box thinking. When and there, the dynamically changing environment, all these pandemic situation, it gives a lot of input for us, all the online classes and so on. So such a way the dynamic changes are happening everywhere, not only in the industries, in the educational service institution also the same thing is happening. This out of box thinking, to give the innovative solutions to issues. So always we are having innovative solutions like online classes. Previously, before pandemic, we don't have such inception in that. But now we learned from this situation. Such a innovative solution to issues, immediate issues, crisis management. So always the critical analysis and the crisis management is a policy of leadership. That is what we are following.
Right, sir. Sir, yes. Rightly said, sir. It is very important to think outside the box during tough times, so that to differentiate yourself from the other people. So
yes
sir. So sir, there is one more thing, sir. What can an inbound student gain from studying here from DRP Engineering College? If any student who is coming from who is not from Trichy and visiting the campus, yes, and studying there, What can be the major gains that the student can gain from studying at DRP Engineering College?
So we are giving nowadays in a global scenario outcome based education. Always the students, whatever the students, they are putting a small input from their side. It may be the money, or it may be the knowledge, or it may be the hard work, whatever it may be. There should be some outcome. That outcome-based education is our motive. It is a globally also, everybody they are saying that outcome-based education is very important. So in this way, we are giving not only the regular engineering curriculum teaching, apart from that, value addition to the students through the skill development. Value addition in the sense from the day one, from the first year, when they are entering into the class, from day one, apart from the regular curriculum, they are getting value-added education also pertaining to their campus corporate connect programming, whatever the industries are expecting from our students. So that is what the value addition we are giving parallel with the regular curriculum. That is the first gain they can get it. The another thing is, for the placement purpose, always they are coming for this particular higher education only for their career development. So in that aspect, the first career development is the placement, immediate campus placement. For the placement, they need a lot of skill. Apart from their regular degree knowledge, they need skill. That kind of skill development for the placement training, from the first year onwards, we are giving first. Yes. The third thing is, now the engineering and all the area is coming around the globe. So the international relationship is very, very important. For that purpose, in our institution, we are giving different kind of foreign languages such as Japanese, French, Spanish, and German. So what are all the languages are leading in the world? So we are giving all these languages training. Right. That is a very important thing, because always we are thinking about the global scenario. Now we cannot, within the shell of state-wise or country-wise, they must groom. They are having career all around the world. So the international relationship maintenance, and we are having a lot of MOU with international universities. We are getting MOU for faculty exchange program, student exchange program with the various global universities. And apart from that, internship, we are making arrangement for the institute in industry internship, partnership cell. Through that, we are making arrangement for the internship, in-plant training, industrial visit. Whenever they are studying here, they can also learn the corporate requirements and the industrial, direct industrial experience, they can have it. And apart from all those things, always the students will like the campus, campus life, like cultural activities, sports activities, because after these 4 years, they will go behind the career development. But these 4 years will give a lot of experience about their life skills. So we are having separate campus life activities, separate cell for it. So these are all the gains they can have. Apart from their career gaining, they can learn the life skills also. So right. This is what our specialty in our campus.
Right, right, sir. Sir, so like as you said, that there are a lot of internships and other programs to ensure that the student is getting the best out of the course. So apart from that, sir, what does the curriculum of TRP Engineering College, how does it ensure the best practice of the industry?
Yes, sir. So when we are talking about the curriculum, even though we are talking about the international relationship, value-added courses, placement training, and also even we are developing a lot of projects through our management financial assistance schemes, innovative projects. So apart from all these requirements, the foundation is nothing but the curriculum. The basic degree is very important for any students. For that only, they are spending 4 years here. So as of now, we are coming under the Anna University. Anna University affiliation, the very strong curriculum Anna University has given. And we are having a very good environment, classroom teaching environment, even though if it is online or offline, for both of the things, we are having a very good faculty members. It is experienced, renowned faculty, learned and faculty members are there. So with that, we are having the up to the mark of our industrial expectations. Definitely, we can give the academic, it's a very strong academic to the students. It is only possible by the experienced, qualified teachers. So as we said, we are having both environment, learning environment, a very strong faculty members, qualified members. Yeah. So both the combination, we can easily achieve this best outcome of curriculum.
Right. Sir, so talking about the faculties, so sir, how do you train the faculties to according to the industry standards, or like going beyond what is like required actually for the course?
Sir, first of all, for any faculty members, they always, whenever we are talking about the faculty members, they must be the learners. It is a lifelong learning is required for any faculty members. We are giving a lot of motivation to the faculty to develop their knowledge then and there dynamically. For that purpose, we are arranging so many faculty development programs. Our faculty members are attending a lot of faculty development programs international level. Apart from that, many industrial visits we are making then and there for there to understand the industrial scenario. We are having contact with the industry people, that is HR people and top level industry technicians. And above all, the teachers are also going for internship, week internship or a monthly internship they are going. So it is a better learning environment for them to understand about the industry. And apart from that, they are almost all the faculty members are without any break consecutively, they are doing their research. So from that research aptitude, they can learn so many things always. So where the teaching fact, I mean, profession is always required, lifelong learning. So we are motivating our teachers to do that. They are also doing it. So in that way, we are keeping up our teachers to achieve this.
Right, sir. Sir, so what do you think should be the college's top priority over the next 10 years?
Yes, sir. As already told, almost all the students, our students, they must excel in technically and in the career, in their career throughout the world. Now, as already told that, they should not shrink within this state or within this country. They must glow all around the world. That is our top priority. So in that way, we are trying to connect with the topmost industries as well as topmost institutions, universities. Right. And keep on, we are putting MOU with these institutions.
Right.
Then entrepreneurship development skill. Always we are talking about the campus connect or job, not only the job oriented, regular corporate jobs. We are also making, to when we are having the mind in our mind for the national development, it is for our country, in Indian scenario, entrepreneurship cell is functioning towards this, develop the entrepreneurship skills among the students. So always within 10 years, almost most of the thousands of our students may be the business owners or industry owners. So this is also one of our vision. And research laboratories, we are trying to, now itself, we are having the Center of Excellence Research Laboratories. This research laboratories, to the national level, to the international level, we must improve the facilities of our research laboratories in the institution itself. And accreditation, already we are in the accreditation process, and we must achieve the global level accreditation like ABET and all. So this is what within 10 years we need to achieve autonomous. So many things are there in the lineup. Definitely we will achieve it. All our faculty members are working as a team for the purpose of this.
Sure.
And one more thing I want to say, each and every point of these things, our management is giving lot of support. So without that support, we cannot do it. But there also, with the visionary leadership of our chairman, sir, we are having a lot of things in our pipeline, and also we are doing it. I hope with all the people like you, your support, we can achieve it.
Sure.
Thank you.
So also, like, amidst all this competition within the students, or like regarding a lot of the curriculum and everything, how do you tend to establish a healthy environment in the college?
When we are saying about the environment of the institution, now we can create a comfortable space for them, first of all, for the students. Whatever they are thinking, they can implement technically. That is an innovative purpose. Our faculty members are supporting for that. And immediately we are giving recognitions and rewards for the faculty members, for the students. Definitely any human being requires this kind of motivation. Definitely, we are doing it in our campus. And always our team work. The team is connected each other. The network with the team is excellently working out here. And almost the people, most of the students are coming from the rural background because of the center of Tamil Nadu. So always they are having the team mentality. So definitely it is very much helpful for our environment. And similarly, we are having a lot of freedom to share our views and thoughts, not only in the administrators level, from the student, from the faculty members, from each and every one of us, we are sharing our thoughts. So definitely this environment will help us to share our views. Then we are training the students, not only for the purpose of employees, just for the employees. We are grooming them for the leadership quality, with the leadership quality. So many administrative qualities providing with them whenever they are doing the functions, small functions in the department. They are taking care of coordinating all these things. So the leadership quality is being imbibed to the students. Then healthy discussions among the employees, solutions, not only the discussion, the solution we are getting from our team, from the student, from the employee. And because of this, they are taking their own responsibility by their own. So automatically, the holistic development is possible. We are giving that kind of environment here.
Right, sir. So lastly, sir, one more thing I would like to ask is, any suggestions you would like to give to the aspiring students?
Yes, sir. For aspiring students, particularly for the engineering aspirants, as we all know that field is always grooming and glooming. So in this way, high personal and academic standard for yourself is very important. Any aspiring students, just aspiration is not enough. Whenever we are having some aspiration, as a particularly in the engineering field, academic standards must be high. Apart from that, the personal development, personality development, that personally they must achieve something, they must have within them. Then they must keep on doing it, and they may follow it, the live up with that. Apart from that, listen the another voice. That is very, very important. You must listen first, and then only we can do this. So without listening, we cannot do anything. And believe yourself, realize that college is a place to develop your skills. Definitely, we are developing all your skills. So you must believe it. The college is going to develop our skills. That particular period, a 4 years period, as already told, our campus is giving a lot of campus life activities. But that is not only for the playing. It is for the administrative, developing leadership skill, developing other skill required for the outside world. So settle for nothing less than your very best. This is what my suggestion to our aspiring students.
Right. Sir, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts on education.